Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Students, today we are studying chapter Kingdom Animalia, and in that we are studying topic Phylum Ctenophora. Now, Ctenophora are aquatic organisms who have some features which are quite distinct from other phyla. So let's study and find out these distinct features today. The phylum organisms, or the organisms that belong to this phylum, are basically umbrella in shape, or they are U-shaped. Also, they are free swimmers in nature. They are mostly aquatic, and their digestion is both intracellular as well as it can be extracellular depending upon the requirement of that particular organism. One special feature of Ctenophores is that they have not having sexes separately. In simple language, the male and the female is never separate. They are a kind of hermaphrodite, if I can say. Male and female are present in one organism, which also makes them reproduce sexually quite fast. In case of separate male and female, the mating can take some time, but if the gametes are present in the same organism, the mating is quite fast. Phylum Ctenophora basically has combo jelly organisms, or jelly-like structurous organisms. Now, they are marine and diploblastic in nature. When I say diploblastic, they have only two germ layers, and organisms who have all the three germ layers are triploblastic. They have got radial symmetry, and when I speak about radial symmetry, it means that their division actually starts from the point of center, or the center axis allows their division point. For the purpose of locomotion, they have ciliated combs with them. As another organism, there are cilia-like structures, they have ciliated combs with them. Now, sexes in these organisms is never separate, or they don't have separate male and female. It's just one male having both the gametes. So the reproduction is obviously sexual. There is an intracellular extracellular digestion which is seen depending upon the system. Now, Pleurobiachia is one of the examples of this. Also, they sometimes prefer living in groups if they found out that there could be some danger or hurt to them. So students, this was Ctenophora phylum, and I hope you all are clear with this concept. Thank you.